Well, today the Minneapolis City Council is weighing whether police officers or businesses should have to pay a fee when officers use the department's equipment while working security jobs off duty. John Croman heard from some council members about why they say a change is needed. John?
Hey, Julie, there's a long tradition across the United States of police officers moonlighting in their off time using city patrol cars, uniforms, and firearms in those private security gigs. Well, some city council members are looking for major reforms in how the Minneapolis Police Department handles that. And today, a committee asked for a study on how much those off-duty jobs are costing taxpayers.
Minneapolis is under a 1997 court order to allow officers to work security jobs while off duty using their city-issued gear and police vehicles.
We do not see that extended to any other department.
City Council Member Robin Wansley says the taxpayers should be compensated for that with a fee on the businesses that hire them.
Want to make sure they're standardized, accurate fees that business owners know that they will have to pay if they are soliciting services for officers for off-duty work.
The issue came into sharp focus in 2017 because Officer Mohamed Noor had worked a 7-hour private security shift before going on police duty the night he fatally shot Justine Ruszcyzk in South Minneapolis.
By having a fee associated with this, this will allow us to make sure that we're tracking those moments so that we're not overworking those officers.
A city audit in 2019 showed that 71% of officers worked at least one off-duty security shift that year, while 8% of officers did so much moonlighting they exceeded the 64-hour work week 5 times that year. The MPD was unable on short notice to provide updated moonlighting figures, but during Monday's meeting, Councilmember Lene Palmisano said the department has better data now.
We do know that Chief O'Hara has implemented some very significant policy changes so that the city knows when and where his police are working with significant penalties if we don't.
Palmisano said the best system would be for the city to directly bill businesses for the officers working off-duty gigs, but she believes that's not allowed under the 1990s court order.
Right now, the only changes that can be made are outlined in that settlement agreement, and this isn't one of them.
We reached out to the Minneapolis Police Federation, which is the officers union, and the Minnesota Police and Peace Officers Association. Neither one of them wanted to comment today about this moonlighting fee proposal. MPD is also not talking about it, and they do plan to provide us more data when it becomes available. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, John.